It's undeniably an Invictus style smell. Hey, what's up guys, it's Josh here. I want to share my two cents today on a very nice fragrance from the House of Armagh, actually one of my favorites so far from them, and they are a great house, so that's pretty hard to come by. Rixos, man, now this fragrance has a lot going for it and a decent amount holding it back at the same time. I was gonna write up like the full notes for this fragrance, but I couldn't really find it on Fragrantica. I couldn't really find like a normal database for the notes, things like that. It's supposed to copy Invictus. I've smelled Invictus a lot, and I gotta say, it smells very, very close to Invictus for me. I own the super strong 2016 Invictus Aqua, so that's what I've been comparing it to. I've already worn this a few days. It's so easy to wear. It definitely smells very close to Invictus. Not gonna be going over too much of the specifics and notes, just gonna be kind of comparing it to Invictus Aqua and generally what I think of Invictus. Definitely more fruity compared to Invictus Aqua. Invictus Aqua kind of is tugging between this aquatic, musky, fruity scent, whereas I get a lot more of the fruits in Armagh Rixos. It's undeniably an Invictus style smell. It also smells really smooth. Invictus has a smooth kind of sweet quality to it. Notice something like Hunter Intense, which I felt like incorporated parts of Invictus. Hunter Intense is a more rough kind of smell, and a lot of times our mauves, they go after musky fragrances, and usually they copy them very well, but the musk is a little rough. This fragrance is very, very smooth. It's not rough at all. It might even be smoother, maybe, than the 2016 Invictus Aqua, but in my opinion, the 2016 Invictus Aqua is so great because it performs so strong, but there's a little bit of this smell in the base. It's a little off-putting. It adds strength to it, but also once the top notes go away, you just smell the base and it's a little like off-putting, like the slightest bit. Although I love Invictus Aqua 2016, just like everyone else. I don't really get almost any of that rough vibe with the Rixos, but I do get 5 to 10% more of it for this fruity quality, which kind of makes it a little bit more normal, but it also takes away from that little bit of roughness that I have in Invictus Aqua. And again, I would always prefer 2016 Invictus Aqua to anything else. I love how strong it is, and I like that it's unique and not exactly smelling like Invictus. So I just wanted to point out that it does have a little bit of roughness to it. I can't lie there, but I have worn it at least for one day, but probably for 2 or 3 days, because I know that I enjoy this scent. It smells like, definitely by Armagh, the closest thing you can get to Invictus. And this bottle is honestly really nice. It's heavy, it's glass, it's kind of different, but I just really, really enjoy it. It feels like a much higher quality than other Armaghs. I like that they go for different style bottles. I know other people don't like that their caps mess up, things like that, but this one, absolutely no bottle issues. Very heavy, high quality bottle as well. The only problem with this one that I could really say is it probably doesn't last as long as 2016 Invictus Aqua, which is notorious for lasting a very, very long time. The Invictus Aqua that they have now is weaker than the one I'm testing it against. So I do definitely want to say that I noticed this one has a little bit of a dip in performance compared to Invictus Aqua. But like I said, I'm going off the stronger batches. This is probably around as much as Invictus projects nowadays. I would say it's got a solid hour and a half, maybe 2 hours projection, and probably 8 to 10 hours on the skin scent. Not weak, but not great at the same time, right in the middle. And the only problem with this one is it's about $30-$35 online. It may be discontinued, I'm not sure, but I just checked before this review. I found it for $30-$35 on eBay, and then I noticed that they have like a newer version where the bottle's different, so I was like, oh, maybe that's the female version, but the same look, but the color's different, and it says man under it. I don't know if that was misspelling. I don't know if that's the female version. Maybe they made like a different color of this. Maybe in the future they're going to go to more of a gold bottle. I don't really know. Anyways, guys, Armagh Rixos, very, very solid for the Armagh lover. The only problem with this one is that it's about $30-$35 for the 3.4 ounce. And this copies Invictus, which usually goes for about $50, $55 online, if I'm not mistaken. For like $20 more, you're gonna get the brand name, the unique bottle, the actual scent that it's supposed to copy. So this fragrance, the only problem with it is that it's so price similar to Invictus already. At the same time, I didn't regret this purchase. I really, really like it. And it's one of the best from Armagh's. It just holds it back that it's so close in price to Invictus. eucalyptus, but I think you're gonna be surprised with how good this smells. Our moths have this kind of like off-putting little smell that comes out there every now and again. And like I was saying earlier in the review, this one's very smooth. I like it a lot. So anyways, guys, this is for the Invictus lover. This is probably, if I had to make an Armov top 10 again, this is probably in the middle. Actually really surprised me, one of my favorites. I just wish that it wasn't so similar to a scent that's only $50. Let me know what you think of the video. Let me know what you think of Armov Rixos. And I'm trying out a new microphone right now, so tell me if it is good or if it is bad. We're on the road to 25,000 subscribers, and I couldn't do it without any of you guys' help. You guys are the best. I'm having a great day out here. Hopefully you're having a great day at home. See you all in the next video. Like, pretty solid, not